Lord would speak to somebody here and minister to someone. If you're here and you've never repented of your sins, or you've never received the gift of the Holy Ghost, then this is a good service tonight for that to happen for somebody. Amen. Anybody can get the Holy Ghost. Everybody say anybody. You know who anybody includes? Everybody includes you and me. Amen. And if you're here and you say, well, maybe I've had the Holy Ghost before, Brother Cheryl, but it's been a little while since I've got to where I need to be, well, then this is a good service to get that fire burning again in your soul and in your spirit. Amen. And the Lord willing, if the rapture doesn't come before I get through preaching, we're going to have an altar service. And when we do that, everybody's welcome to come to this altar. And if you need the Holy Ghost, we want you to come with us. And God will fill you with His Spirit, baptize you with His power. Amen. 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 Micah 7 and verse number 8, the Bible said, "Rejoice not against me, O mine enemy. When I fall, I shall rise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord will be a light unto me." Amen. When I fall, I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light unto me. Amen. Let's pray together and ask God to have His way the remainder of this service. God, we thank You for allowing us to be in Your house one more time tonight. Thank You for every individual that's here. And I pray You'd minister to every need. God, as we're trying to do our best to create an atmosphere for the Lord to work and for You to move, I pray, God, that You would speak to hearts. God, I pray that You would talk to the souls that are here tonight. Help me to communicate Your word in an effective way. In Jesus' name we pray. And we give You honor and glory and praise for that. And everybody said, in Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. God bless you tonight. It's easy sometimes in life to get in a place where it seems as though that life will never change, and that the things that we are dealing with and the circumstances that we have, it seems as though that they will never pass and we will never get beyond them, and we have to adjust to the way things are at the present and embrace it as this is just the way that it is. That's the mindset that the enemy would like to have us to have. But I want to help somebody tonight, to do my best to help someone, to let you know that there's nothing that God cannot change. It doesn't matter if it's been that way for one day or 1 year or 10 years or 20 years. There's no limits on God. He can change any situation. Time is no barrier. And just because it's been that way a long time doesn't mean it's more difficult for God to do it as it was if it just happened. God can do anything. And God is able to. always going to be rough, and it's always going to be tough. And this is just the way it is. The reality is, I was expecting to get in the vehicle and for it to be rough and for it to be tough. But I had kind of forgotten the way that things were in a vehicle that's got shocks and power steering and foam seats and air conditioning. I got used to this element and just thinking that this is it. This is the way that it is. And I know that may not be the greatest spiritual illustration, but hopefully somebody can find a little common ground there. Because sometimes that's the way it is in life. Life gets rough, and life gets tough, and life gets hard. And sometimes the devil makes you think this is just the way life is. And you fail and you forget that there is a place in God where the Lord can turn those things around and God can change your life and God can smooth things out. Hallelujah. God did not intend for life to always be hard and for life to always be rough and for life to always be tough. Amen. He said, I've come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. Jesus didn't go to Calvary. He didn't go to the grave. He didn't rise on the third day for us to live a miserable, distraught, tough life. Amen. He went to Calvary so we can live a life of victory and dominion and power. Hallelujah. That's the will of God. Hallelujah. He didn't go to Calvary so we can get rich. He didn't go to Calvary so we can all be millionaires. He never gave us a promise that we would all have fleshly comfort. He did make a promise that we would have spiritual comfort. Amen. You may not have everything that your flesh desires. He said, but the promise I'm going to give you is I'm going to give you a comforter on the inside. You may not always be comfortable in your flesh, but I'm going to comfort your spirit. It's not always going to have to be hard and tough and rough. Hallelujah. I'm going to bring comfort and peace to your soul. Hallelujah. Permanent as the enemy would like us to believe. Hallelujah. John the Baptist.
He said, the Lord is going to be a light unto me. When I don't know what to do, you can bank on it. The Lord is going to come into my darkness, and he's going to shine light in my darkness. He's going to tell me where to go. He's going to tell me what to do. He's going to give me direction. The Lord is going to be a light unto me.
Oh!
then there's some falls that are more devastating than others. It's the devil's prerogative and objective is to keep you going in the wrong direction. And that direction is away from God and away from Jesus Christ. And when you're going away from the Lord, you're going down. Moving away from God, there is no lateral movement. Away from the Lord, it's downward motion.
Praise God. Down
is not a destination, so to speak. Down is a direction. You don't reach down and say, well, I've reached down. Down is a direction. There's no place really called down. We hear rock bottom, there's really no rock bottom.
That's right. Come on.
Because down keeps going.
Right. Amen.
Because it's a direction, it's not a destination. Up is a direction.
I'm here.
I say I'm going up. Well, I've reached up. I'm going up, but I haven't reached up because there's another up. I'm going to go up again. Because I like that direction, I'm going to go up. But since I've reached here, I still haven't reached it. I can keep on going. Because up is a direction.
Amen. So we have to decide what direction we want to go in.
And it's really either up or down. And if you're moving toward the Lord, you're moving up. And if you're moving away from the Lord, you're essentially moving down. Individual we call the prodigal son. How he came to his father and he told his father, divide to me my portion of goods. And he did, and after a while he took his goods and he left the father's house. When he left the father's house, he didn't have to, we know he ended up in the hog pen. But the first step out of the father's house was a step in the down direction. Down wasn't at the hog pen. Down was when he decided to leave the father's house. That was the first step in the down direction.
Amen.
So he left the father's house. Then he went, the Bible said, to a far country because he's going down. He didn't get to the far country and say, well, this is low as it gets. I'm a long way from home. It ain't going to get no worse than this. No, because he's going down.
Amen.
Because he got to the far country, and then the Bible said he took all and spent all of his living. Amen. Well, you could say, well, he's down now. Boy, it don't get no worse than that. A long way from home and empty pockets. But if you keep going down, down keeps going because it's a direction. So then there comes a famine in the land. You can say, man, it ain't going to get no worse than this. I'm a long way from home, empty pockets, and there's nothing to eat. There's a famine in this land. Surely it can't get no worse than this. But it can get worse than that because it's a direction. And as long as you keep going down, down keeps going. As long as you want to take that road. Somebody say hallelujah. You're not going to reach a place and say, well, it's never going to get any worse than this. But if you keep going in that direction, you'll find out there's another level to down, and then there's another level to down, and then there's another level to down. But at some point, you got to make up your mind, I'm tired of going down. I'm tired of this. I got to turn this ship around. I've got to go to the up direction. Spent all his living with the family of the land. And then the Bible said he joined himself to a citizen of that country.
and he found employment feeding the hogs or the swine. And he's there. Well, sure, we can't get no worse than this. I'm in a far country. I've spent all my money. There's a famine in the land. And look at where I am. I'm now feeding the swine. Which was a disgrace to this young Jewish boy. Then, as his stomach is rumbling, and he's hungry, he sees the husk that the swine would eat. And he came close to eating the swine's slop. But apparently it dawned on him that if I'm naive enough to think that if I eat this pig slop and it ain't going to get no worse, I got another thing coming. Because it keeps going. Because I'm living, it goes down, 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 down. And if I eat the pig stew, it's going to go down from there. And if there's something else that's going to go down from there, it's really up to me if I want to arise or not. And if I want to get up or not. And if I want to change this direction or not. And the Bible said that while he's sitting there eating or feeding the swine and about to eat the food that the swine eat, he came to himself and he said, in my father's house, the servants have bread enough and to spare. He said, I will arise and I will go up to my father's house. When you're in that place, I don't care how far you're away, how bad it is, the getting up part, it depends on you. The getting up part is the choice you got to make. And if you're ready to get up, I shall arise. I'm going to get up. It's my choice. It's my decision to do that. I said, well, I need to find out some answers here. And this guy's in the same place I'm in. He's in the same boat I'm in. He's in the same stinking mess I'm in. And I turn to him and say, hey, man, this is bad. What do you think about it? Do you think this is bad as I think it is? Well, chances are, he's not going to tell you what you need to hear. Because he's in the same hall that you are. And if he invites you, that means he's indicted himself. So he's silver lining to it, you know. I mean, maybe there's a silver lining here somewhere. You understand the point that I'm making? You can't go to other people in the same boat you're in to get truth. You got problems? You can't go to somebody else with the same problem and say, what if they're going to do my problem? Because if they deny you, they deny themselves. So they won't smooth it over to you, so make themselves look good. Amen. So if you're going to get truth every now and then, you got to come to yourself. And you got to be honest with yourself. And you got to say, self, you know you don't have to be here. And you know there's a better way. And you know there's a better life. And you know there's a God that loves you. And you know there's a God that cares for you. And if you're going to do what you need to do, you got to come to the truth. And you got to come to honesty with yourself. And say, God, I've got a better way. Holy Ghost, and I need it, and I'm going to arrive, and I'm going to hold to the bodies. I don't know what you're dealing with tonight, but there's a Father here with open arms and saying, you can come my way, and I'm going to score, and I'm going to redeem. Set his face toward the Father's house.
Come on. Come on.
And he made one step
that's it, right
out of
there.
That hall pen toward the Father's house. That was a step in the up direction. I'm telling you, every step you make toward the Lord is a step in the up direction. Hallelujah. You're tired of the downward spiral, and you're tired of the darkness, and you're tired of, I don't know what's going to happen next. Maybe it's time to turn around and say, I'm going that way. I'm going to take a step up. I'm going to take a step up. I'm going to the altar. I'm going up. I'm going to get baptized. I'm going up. I need the Holy Ghost. I'm stepping up.
is just important as being baptized in Jesus' name. And repentance is just as important as being filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost. Repentance is an essential part of salvation. If you haven't repented, you need to repent. Don't overlook repentance, because it's a big step. And if you haven't repented, you need to repent in your sins and say, God, here I am. I ain't got it all together, but I'm turning around. And I'm here to take steps in your way, Lord, in your direction. And I repent of my sins. I'm sorry. Forgive me of my sins, God. When you repent, repentance, when you turn around, when you put your back on sin, and you start walking in the other direction, repentance changes your present life. Sin, you do your best to turn around and you start walking the other direction. Repentance changes your present lifestyle.
Amen. Amen.
When you say, I'm ready for the next step, and you go to the water and you're baptized in the name of Jesus for the remission of your sin.
Amen.
Baptism in water in Jesus' name remits all of your sin. School, we had the old chalkboards, and I don't know if they still have that. But they had the erasers, and they put the chalk on there, and the board would be full. And after class, you'd find the teacher there. She'd be erasing everything. Or she'd tell one of the students to go up there and erase everything. And then by the time you left, that chalkboard was clean. And you look at our lives before we come to God. Brother, they are marked up, they are scarred up, they are messed up, they got all kinds of stuff on. But when you go down in Jesus' name, it's like the Lord takes his divine eraser and he just cleans the whole slate of your life. Jesus, I feel that. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. It's time to step up. It's time to step up. So, changes your present life. Baptism changes your past life. Repentance, baptism, and the infilling of the Holy Ghost. This is what it is. I know I'm presenting it to you in a nutshell here. But when you repent, it changes your present life. When you're baptized, it changes your past life. And then when God fuels you with the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and you obey the gospel, you are changed, past, present, and future. Hallelujah. All things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. It's time to step up and move in the other direction. God said it's time to get up. Hallelujah. Jesus told the man to rise up and walk. The Bible said he that was dead sat up. When Jesus prayed, he went up. He said, destroy this temple in 3 days and I'll raise it up. Jesus said, I'll give you a well that springs up. Zacchaeus climbed up. Jesus came to him and looked up. He said, when you pray in the Holy Ghost, you're going to be built up. He said, when we come to God, we are raised up. And when it's time to go to heaven, we're going to be called out. He's in the business of carrying us in the up direction. Start moving toward God and God starts working in your life. God starts to pull you up, pick you up.
may have told last time. I can't remember, so pardon me if I did. But my wife would go and pick her up and bring her back down to the corner to a little eating establishment, and I think it was Thursday mornings, she'd go get her, buy her something to eat, and then open the Bible, teach her a little Bible study there at that little fast food restaurant. And this lady, she was a young lady, but, you know, I don't want to go into detail, but her life was a picture of the horrible results of sin, that sin can do in somebody's life. You can imagine any and everything that she had been a part of, and the broken pieces and the misery that was in her life. Her life was a wreck. My wife would go pick her up. She was staying with somebody. Bring her back. Teach her a Bible study. And she would come to church. And this began to go on weekly. And every week she would go get her. My wife would come back and she would tell me what had happened. And her name was Bonnie. And Bonnie would tell my wife, "Sister Cheryl, you won't believe what happened to me this week.
Come on.
She's moving toward God. You know. She's taking steps in the up direction. She's repented of her sins. Next week, she was getting baptized. And as this process begins to go, transpire, Bonnie begins to tell my wife, "I can't believe what God's doing. It's not just salvation, but it's other areas of life. They've been so rough for so long. And all of a sudden they start to smooth." I'm not saying everything's going to be peachy from now on, but I'm talking about God can start working things out. And I feel the Holy Ghost right now. You just... Sister Cheryl, you won't believe. I got a job this week. I couldn't get a job. I got a job. Now, that's not big to some people, but for her life, it was a big deal. Because she's going up. Hey, I got me a car this week. You know how long it's been since I had a car? I got a car. I can come to church by myself. Going up. The next week, hey, I got my own apartment. I got my own place. The next week, hadn't seen my two kids in years. I seen them this week for the first time in years. How did that happen? And you just begin to see things begin to move. And to work and to take shape and to start to click and to start to work out. Because when you start moving toward God, God not only just can save your soul, but every area of your life, God wants to get in it and fill the void and to work in every part of your life. Clocks. I don't know if they make them like this anymore, but my mom's got an old antique clock in her house. And she got a little key to it. And you have to take that key and open that deal up, and you have to wind that thing up, and you turn that clock around. There ain't no AAA batteries. There ain't no 9-volt batteries. I mean, it's a real all kind of little wheels and gadgets and all kind of stuff back there. And you turn that clock around, and there's all kind of little wheels, little gears, all kind of stuff. But there's always one big wheel. And if you can never get that big wheel to turn, all the other little deals, they have to turn with it. With it. Hallelujah.
Sometimes we frustrate ourselves to death because we're trying to work on this and we're trying to work on this and we're trying to fix this and we're trying to do this and we're trying to make this happen and all the wheel. I'm not trying to paint God in the wrong way. Please don't misunderstand me. But all the time, the big wheel ain't working and the big wheel's just sitting there. But if you can ever turn to God and say, God, I can't do all this. I just need to get you working. I just need to get you moving. I just need to get you operating in my life. And God steps into your life and automatically all the other areas of your life begin to click, begin to turn, begin to work because you start moving in the up direction. It's a lift of the Holy Ghost. Can we lift our hands to the Lord together here tonight? Musicians, if you'll come, everybody, let's lift our hands. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 I bless your name, God. I magnify you, Father. I lift you up, oh God. Hallelujah. 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 Down doesn't have to be your direction. There's a God here. He said, if you turn toward me, and you come my way, and you start coming up, and you start moving up, and you wave bye to the famine, and you wave bye to the far country, and you wave bye to the misery and the pain, and you're saying, pardon me, but I'm going up. I'm going toward the cross. I'm going toward the Lord. I'm going toward Jesus Christ. Would you stand with me together here this evening? God, we need you now. God, you know every individual that's here. God, every man and every woman. God, every person that's under the sound of my voice here tonight. God, I'm praying that the Holy Ghost and that the Spirit of God would draw, work, and speak. Help to convince somebody they don't have to spend all of their life going down. There's another direction. When you walk toward God, it takes me up. It takes me up. It takes me up toward Him. If you're here tonight and you haven't repented of your sins, let me come to this altar in just a moment. Come and repent of your sins. The devil hates that because you're stepping up. If you say, hey, I've never been baptized in Jesus' name, you get a hold of one of these ministers here and you say, we need to make arrangements here because I want to get baptized in Jesus' name. I'm stepping up. I'm going up. I don't have the Lord in my life. I need the Holy Ghost. When you come to this altar, join us at this altar tonight. God will fill you and baptize you with the Holy Ghost. I'm coming up. I need the Holy Ghost. I need the Spirit of God working and moving and operating in my life. I need it. Hallelujah. I'm coming. I'm coming in the other direction toward God. We're going to come to this altar, but before we do, I want us all to go to the Lord in prayer. And I want us to pray. And I want us to pray that if there's anybody here that God may be talking to in this house. God, that you would remove every obstacle, and you would remove every hindrance that the enemy's trying to place in front of them. And you would allow them, God, to step out and move toward you. Come on, can we pray together right now that God would just work in this altar service, Lord, in your mighty name. God, you said that your word would not return void, but it would accomplish that which you please, and it would prosper in the thing whereto you sent it. I pray now that the word of God would go forth as it has been going forth. God, that it would accomplish what you sent it to do, and it would prosper in the thing whereto you sent it, God. Confirm your word, O Lord. Let somebody here know, God, that you're for them. God, you've got something for them. God, in the your situation doesn't have to be permanent. God, but mountains can come down and valleys can come up. Crooked places can be made straight. Rough places can be made smooth. God, that with you the permanent can be temporary. In the name of Jesus Christ, I'm asking God in Jesus' name that your will would be accomplished in the name of Jesus Christ. As they play and begin to sing something here, if there's anybody here,